Dear students, today's topic of my lecture, magnetic effect of current, part 3. In it, what you have to learn? Let you see here. First, we understand the concept of force on a current carrying conductor in a uniform magnetic field. Then force between two parallel long current carrying conductors of infinite length, then definition of ampere, then representation of magnetic fields due to parallel currents, at last torque experienced by current carrying coil or loop in a uniform magnetic field. So first we start force on a current carrying conductor in a uniform magnetic field. So for that purpose we consider PQ conductor of length L, area of cross section A, placed in uniform magnetic field which makes an angle theta with its axis. Let I current is flowing through the conductor, VdV the drift velocity of electrons, then a force experienced by the current carrying conductor, F vector. Then we find volume of the conductor, that is AL. And if we say that small n be the number of free electrons per unit volume, then small n equal to capital N upon AL, where capital N is the total number of free electrons, then it becomes capital N equal to small n AL. Now, we will calculate force on each free electron. And after that, we multiply that force by the total number of free electrons. Then we get the total force experienced by all free electrons, and that force is the force experienced by current carrying conductor. Right? So let us see, force experienced by each free electron is F vector equal to minus E within bracket Vd vector cross B vector. And that formula you have already studied, that is F vector equal to QB cross B. Here in place of charge, it is minus E, charge on electron. In place of V, drift velocity. So by that formula, we can say that the force experienced by each free electron is small f vector equal to minus E within bracket Vd vector cross B vector. Now total force experienced by all free electrons, that is equal to capital F equal to capital N, total number of free electrons multiplied by small f. So in vector form we write F vector equal to capital N small f vector. Mark this equation number 1. Then substitute the value of N. Then we will get F vector equal to minus N A L E within bracket is Vd vector cross B vector. Now we write it in magnitude form. So we will get F equal to minus N A L E Vd B sine theta. Now from the relation between the current and drift velocity, you know that I is equal to A N E Vd. So in place of A N E Vd, we can write capital I. So this equation that becomes F equal to I L B sine theta, where I is equal to N E A Vd or A N E Vd. And negative sign indicates that the direction of current is opposite to the direction of drift velocity. So here you can see in the diagram, direction of the current is opposite to the direction of drift velocity. So that's why we are taking negative sign. So in magnitude, what we write? F equal to ILB sine theta. Mark this equation 2. In vector form, we write F vector equal to I within bracket is L vector cross vector. So this is the force on current carrying conductor in a uniform magnetic field. Now we take some special cases. Say when theta equal to 0 degree or 180 degree, then sine 0 or 180 is 0. So that's why the force experienced by current carrying conductor placed in uniform magnetic field with parallel or anti-parallel, then it will not experience any force. And that you can also understand by the formula F equal to ILB sine theta. So in place of sine theta, you put sine 0 or 180 degree, which is 0. So that's why F equal to 0. So from here, we can say that if a current carrying conductor is placed parallel or anti-parallel to the direction of magnetic field, then the conductor will not experience any force. Now, if we say that if theta equal to 90 degree or sine 90 equal to 1, then apply the formula F equal to ILB sine 90. Sine 90 is 1, then you will get F equal to ILB, which is the maximum value. Then a current carrying conductor will experience maximum force when it is placed at right angle to the direction of magnetic field. Now, how the direction of the force we determine? The direction of the force is perpendicular to the plane containing L vector and B vector, and that can be determined by the right hand rule for cross product. And what is that right hand rule? Now, if you stretch your right hand finger outward and its orientation towards nail represents the direction of magnetic field, then extended thumb will point in the direction of force on the conductor. So as you see that you have taken in the diagram the conductor and the current is flowing like that. So these outstretched fingers, they are representing the direction of current. And when we orient fingers, that is wrap the fingers towards the nail, that represents the direction of magnetic field. Then this thumb will represent the direction of force on the current carrying conductor. So this is about right hand rule. Now we take some example. We are taking a straight wire PQ of mass 200 gram and length 1.5 meter, carries a current 2 ampere. It is suspended in mid air by uniform magnetic field. Then what is the magnitude of magnetic field? आपको उस condition में magnitude of magnetic field निकालना है. And PQ conductor's mass is given to you 200 gram. Length is given 1.5 meter and the current flowing through the conductor is 2 ampere. So what you have to do? You apply the formula F equal to ILB sine theta and F equal to mg. Then you see that in diagram it is cross cross cross, means magnetic field perpendicular to the plane acting inward. So that's why theta is 90 degree. So you will get F equal to ILB sine 90 equal to mg, then ILB equal to mg, and after that B equal to mg upon IL. Now you convert 200 gram into the kg, that is 200 into 10 is power minus 3, g is 9.8, I is given 2 ampere, multiplied by length is 1.5 meter. So after the calculating, you will get 0.653 Tesla. So this is the magnetic field which is experienced by current carrying conductor PQ. Now we take another example. Current of 5 ampere is flowing upward in a long vertical wire, and this wire is placed in uniform northward magnetic field of 0.2 Tesla. How much force and in which direction will this field exert on 0.06 meter length of the wire? So you see that what is given? Current is given, magnetic field is given, force you have to find out, right? Then you have the formula F equal to ILB sine theta, and theta is 90 degrees given. So F equal to ILB sine 90 degree equal to ILB. Now you substitute the values. Current is 5 ampere, 5 into length is 0.06 into B 0.02 Tesla. and when you solve it, you will get 0.006 Newton. And now the direction of the force, that is towards west. Because if you say that the north direction is this, then this is the north direction, and the direction of the current along to the direction of the wire, then this thumb will represent the direction of force, and which is towards west. So apply right hand rule and then find the direction of that is towards west. Now force between two parallel infinitely long current carrying conductor. So for that purpose, we consider the two current carrying infinite long conductors, say PQ and RS, carrying the current I1 and I2. So what happens, you see that when I1 current is flowing in conductor PQ, then there is a magnetic field around the conductor PQ. By the right hand thumb rule, you can find out the direction of magnetic field lines, that is anti-clockwise. And similarly here in RS is also anti-clockwise. And PQ is in the magnetic field of RS and RS is in the magnetic field of PQ. So due to this magnetic interaction, these two conductors, they will experience the force. They are placed at distance small r. Now the magnetic field of the conductor PQ is B1, and the force is acting on the conductor RS towards PQ, and that we are representing by F21, that is force on second conductor due to first conductor. And the direction of this force you can find out by the Fleming's left hand rule. The magnetic field is cross and circle, that is magnetic field perpendicular to the plane and acting inward. So magnetic field inward, the first finger represents the magnetic field, and center finger that represents the direction of current, then thumb will represent the direction of force. So that is towards PQ. So we will find out that force acting onto the conductor RS due to the conductor PQ. That is F21 equal to I2LB1 sin theta. F21 means force on second conductor due to first conductor. I2 current is flowing in second conductor. L is the length of the conductor. B1 is the magnetic field due to the first conductor. That is PQ. So B1 is already you know. B1 equal to mu naught I1 upon 2 pi r. Then you substitute this value here. Then you will get F21 equal to mu naught I1 upon 2 pi r I2L sin 90. Right? And sin 90 is 1. And you then solve it. F21 is equal to mu naught I1 I2 L upon 2 pi r. This is the force, and which is acting towards PQ. And the B1 magnetic field which you are having, it is perpendicular to the plane and into the plane, as I already told you, and that direction we can find out by the right hand thumb rule. Right? Now similarly, PQ conductor also experiences the force due to the magnetic field of conductor RS, which is represented by B2. So here the force experienced by conductor PQ is F12. That is the force experienced by first conductor due to second conductor. Same way we have to find out, that is magnetic field B2 equal to mu naught I2 2 pi r, and then force experienced by conductor PQ due to RS F12 equal to I1 L B2 sin theta, and substitute the value of B2, then you will get F12 equal to mu naught I2 upon 2 pi r I1 L sin 90, and then it becomes F12 equal to mu naught I1 I2 L upon 2 pi r. Then you see that force on conductor RS and force on conductor PQ are the same. So that's why F12 equal to F21 equal to F mu naught I1 I2 L upon 2 pi R. Or we can say that force per unit length of the conductor F upon L equal to mu naught I1 I2 upon 2 pi R. For making the calculation easy, we multiplied right hand side of this equation numerator by 2 and denominator by 2. Then what you will get? You will get F upon L equal to mu naught 2 I1 I2 upon 4 pi R. And mu naught upon 4 pi, you know that its value is 10 raised to power minus 7. So that's why this we can use directly for the concept based and the numericals regarding the force between two infinitely long current carrying conductors. Now, here we are showing two conductors PQ and RS, as in the previous slide is also there. And here these two forces are acting towards each other. So when the currents flowing through the conductor are in the same direction, then the nature of force is attractive. But if direction of current in conductors in opposite direction, then in that condition, the nature of force between the two current carrying conductors is repulsive. This direction of force you can apply or find with the help of the Fleming's left hand rule. So you remember it, when current is flowing in the conductors in the same direction, then the nature of force is attractive. If the current is flowing in opposite direction, then the nature of force is repulsive. Now definition of 1 ampere. So as you know the formula, F upon L equal to mu naught upon 4 pi 2 I1 I2 upon R, or mu naught I1 I2 upon 2 pi R. If we say that I1 equal to I2 equal to 1 ampere and R equal to 1 meter, then when you substitute these value in this equation, then you will get 2 into 10 is power minus 7 Newton per meter. So from here we can define 1 ampere is that steady current or the constant current which if passed in each of the two parallel conductors of infinite length and placed 1 meter apart in vacuum causes each conductor to experience a force 2 into 10 raised to power minus 7 Newton per meter of length of the conductor. That is the definition of 1 ampere. Understand the concept? Then you write the definition. No need to cram the definition. Now, the representation of magnetic field lines due to the parallel conductors. Now, we will see that the pattern of magnetic field around these two current carrying parallel conductors. See here, the same rule that you have to apply, that is right hand thumb rule, like that, hold the conductor in the right hand, then curl of the fingers towards the nail that represents the direction of magnetic field lines and thumb that is representing the direction of the current. So you can see here in both these two conductors, the current's direction is the same, that is in upward direction. So magnetic field lines around these conductors are anticlockwise. But whereas you see that in the second diagram, in first conductor, direction of current is upward and in second, it is downward. So both are in opposite direction. So in that case, in the first conductor, when you apply the right hand thumb rule, then it is anticlockwise, that is magnetic field lines anticlockwise. But here in the second conductor, the direction of current is downward. So the magnetic field lines in clockwise direction. And in first conductor, it is in anticlockwise direction. So this is the field pattern of magnetic field around the current carrying parallel conductors. Now we take one example. As you see that in the figure, a wire PQ is fixed while a square loop ABCD is free to move under the influence of currents flowing in them. State with reason in which direction does the loop begins to move or rotate. You see that here PQ conductor is fixed and ABCD, a square loop is there. Then you see in the direction of the PQ, in conductor PQ, the direction of current is from Q to P. And in AD arm of the square loop, the direction of the current is from D to A. So when you see this AD conductor and PQ conductor, both are having the same direction, right? So nature of force between them is attractive, whereas BC is having the current in opposite direction to the PQ. So that's why the force, nature of force between them is repulsive. Moreover, AD is nearer than BC. So therefore, more force experienced by AD arm than BC arm. So that's why the loop will move towards PQ and the nature of force between them is attractive. Let us see here the answer. The same which I explained, wire PQ and AD will attract each other as the current are in the same direction, while the wire PQ and BC will repel each other as the current are in opposite direction. Contribution due to the currents in AB and CD nullify each other, since the wire PQ AD is nearer than BC, so that net force on the loop is attractive. Therefore, the loop will move towards wire P. So, understand the concept and apply. Then the question becomes easy. Similarly, we take another example. A square loop of side 20 cm carrying current 1 ampere is kept near an infinite long straight wire carrying a current 2 ampere. Like that you see in the diagram. This is the wire which is carrying the current 2 ampere. And this is the square loop whose side is 20 cm carrying the current 1 ampere and which is placed at 10 cm from the long infinite wire carrying the current 2 ampere. Then you have to calculate magnitude and direction of the net force on the loop due to current carrying conductor. Right? So, after understanding the question, we have to solve it. Apply the formula which you learned between the two conductors, that is F upon L equal to mu naught upon 4 pi 2 I1 I2 upon R. Then net force you have to find out, because you have two conductors. This conductor is this, another one is this. Then net force is F upon L equal to mu naught upon 4 pi 2 I1 I2 within bracket 1 upon R1 minus 1 upon R2. R1 is the distance of this conductor from this infinite conductor. And R2 is distance of this conductor from here. So substitute these values here. That is F upon 20 into 10 raised to the power minus 2. This is the length of the conductor equal to mu naught upon 4 pi 10 raised to the power minus 7 into 2. I1 is 2, I2 is 1. That is here this is I1 and this is I2. Right? And R1 is 10 centimeter and R2 is 10 plus 20, 30 centimeters. So you substitute here 1 upon 10 into 10 is power minus 2 minus 1 upon 30 into 10 is power minus 2. And after that, when you calculate it, you will get F equal to 16 upon 3 into 10 is power minus 7. That is 5 into 10 is 5.33 into 10 is power minus 7 newton. Now the direction. As just I explained, the conductor which is having the distance 10 centimeter as comparison to the other conductor whose distance is 30 centimeter from infinite long conductor, it means the attractive force is more than the repulsive force. So that's why the loop moves towards infinite long wire. Same concept which we applied in the previous example for the direction. Now torque experienced by current carrying loop or coil spacely rectangular in uniform magnetic field. So for that purpose we take a rectangular conductor P, Q, R, S placed in uniform magnetic field B at an angle theta. Then a current I is flowing, you can see that from P to Q, R, S, P. Then a force experienced by the conductor SP and conductor QR. Similarly, the force experienced by the conductor PQ and RS also. But first we calculate force on R, SP and QR. So already you know the formula, F equal to ILB sin theta. So here the rectangular current carrying loop which we are taking, whose length is L and breadth is B. So when you apply the formula here, then the force experienced by conductor or arm SP of the rectangular loop, that becomes F SP vector equal to I within bracket B vector cross B vector. So this becomes in magnitude IBB sin theta. Now similarly the force on the arm QR, that is I within bracket B vector cross B vector, and in magnitude form it becomes IBB sin theta. Now you see in the diagram these two forces are equal and opposite, acting on the same line of action, so that's why they cancel each other. So net force on along this axis is zero, and moreover they act along the same line of action, therefore they will not produce any torque. Now we calculate force on arm PQ and RS. So you see that the forces on the arm PQ and RS, here it is PQ, this is towards you, and here it is on RS, it is inward, and PQ is F force F PQ away, that is towards the observer, and RS is inward, right, into the plane, and it is out of the plane. And that's the same way you will find out with the help of the Fleming's left hand rule. So when you apply it, then you see that this is the magnetic field that we are calculating on the arm PQ. This is the magnetic field, this is the direction of the current, and then thumb will represent the direction of force, which is towards the observer, that is out of the plane. Similarly, we will find out there in the arm RS. In RS, what happens? This is the magnetic field, and this is the direction of current, and thumb will represent direction of force, that is into the plane. And these two forces are also equal but acting on the different line of action. So that's why net force is zero, but there is a torque. So you see that here the mathematical form, FPQ vector equal to I L vector cross B, and in magnitude ILB sin 90, which is equal to ILB. Similarly, FRS vector equal to I L vector cross B, and then it becomes ILB sin 90, which is equal to ILB. So magnitude of these two forces are same, so net force is zero, but these two forces are acting on different line of action, so that's why there is a torque, but net force is zero, so that's why translatory motion is not there. So they will not produce any translatory motion. Now we will find out that torque. What is that torque? So for that purpose, again you see the diagram. Here, this is a rectangular current carrying loop, and on the arm PQ, the force is FQ, and on the arm RS, the force is FRS. Right? Then we drop a perpendicular from point P on the arm RS, that is PN. So this is perpendicular distance for both FRS and FPQ, and the torque is force multiplied by perpendicular distance. So torque experienced by the coil is tau equal to FPQ cross PN. Any force you can take, FRS you can also take, and then FPQ, which is equal to ILB, and PN. PN you can take from this diagram, that is from the triangle PNS, cos theta equal to base upon perpendicular. So you will get PN equal to PS cos theta. So which is PN is PS is B, so that becomes B cos theta. So tau equal to ILB B cos theta. Then you rearrange it, then tau equal to ILB capital B cos theta. Small l and small b, that is length into breadth, area of the rectangular loop. So tau equal to A IA B cos theta, where A equal to LB, length into breadth. And then if we say that n be the number of turns of the rectangular loop, then the expression becomes tau equal to N IA B cos theta. Or if we say that a normal drawn on this rectangular loop, which makes an angle phi with the magnetic field, then theta plus phi, that is equal to 90 degree. And that we can say that, suppose we say that this is a rectangular or we can say that this is the rectangular loop, okay, and a magnetic field, and the magnetic field, we say that this is the magnetic field, so that magnetic field makes an angle theta, this is the angle theta, and if this is the normal drawn onto the coil, so this normal which makes an angle phi with magnetic field, and that is equal to 90 degree, that is theta plus phi equal to 90 degree. Then theta equal to 90 minus phi, substitute this value here, then what you will get, tau equal to IAB cos 90 minus phi. Cos 90 minus phi is sin phi. Then tau equal to IAB cos 90 minus phi, and tau equal to NIAB sin phi, or tau equal to BINA sin phi, that is bina sin phi. So here you just understand one important thing, because two factors are there, two expressions are there. One is tau equal to NIA B cos theta. Another one is tau equal to NIA B sin phi. So the concept is very important, so that you cannot be confused while solving the concept based problems and the numericals. Means in this formula, or the one that uses the formula, the term cos phi or sin phi, that since depends on the angle taken whether with the plane of the coil or normal to the coil. If we are saying plane of the coil, then the first formula is applied, tau equal to NIAB cos theta. If we say that normal to the plane, And second, this formula you have to apply tau equal to NIAB sin phi or tau equal to BINA sin phi. So you just remember it, understand this concept very clearly so that no confusion. Now we write this formula in the vector form, that is tau equal to BINA sin phi. Then we can say that tau equal to BINA sin phi n cap, where n cap is the unit vector normal to the plane of the loop. Then we can write it tau vector equal to ni within bracket is a vector cross b vector. So it is a cross product. Or we can say that tau equal to m vector cross b vector, where capital M is the ni a vector, that is magnetic dipole moment of the current carrying loop. So you just remember it. Okay. Now here you note down the some important points so that you will not get confused. The first important point is that coil will rotate in anti-clockwise direction from the top view according to the figure about the axis of the coil shown by the dotted line, the diagram. Okay. Second is torque acts in upward direction along the dotted line according to the Maxwell's screw rule, obviously. And the third, we take two special cases. If we say that phi equal to 0, then tau equal to bina sin phi. Sin phi means sin 0. Sin 0 means 0. Then tau equal to also 0. This is the condition of stable equilibrium. Now, if phi equal to 180 degree, then also tau equal to 0. Because sin 180 is also 0. So tau is 0. So this is the condition of unstable equilibrium. But if phi equal to 90 degree, then tau equal to bina sin 90. Sin 90 is 1, then tau is maximum, which is tau equal to BINA. That just remember by the word bina. So tau max equal to bina. At this condition, the maximum torque experienced by current carrying rectangular loop or coil when loop sets its axis parallel to the direction of magnetic field, and in this condition the magnetic field is called radial magnetic field. So you just understand the concept of the radial magnetic field means when the rectangular loop or the coil which sets its axis parallel to the direction of magnetic field, in that condition you will get the maximum torque, and that is the condition of radial magnetic field. Or in that condition, magnetic field is called radial magnetic field. And the fifth one is this above formula which we are saying tau equal to m vector cross b vector, or tau equal to BINA sin phi, or tau equal to BINA cos theta. And this formula for torque can be used for any loop irrespective of its shape. Just like here we have taken a rectangular loop. If it is a circular loop, also we have to apply the same formula. Now, if you like my video, then like it, subscribe it, press the bell icon. Thank you. Have a nice day.